Shalom. This week we read a portion of Vezot HaBracha, beginning in Deuteronomy, Sefer Devarim, chapter 33. We read of the beautiful, mystical, encompassing blessing that Moshe Rabbeinu, Moses, our master, gave to all of the children of Israel, each according to his tribe, before his death. And of course, these blessings, they contain the secrets of the inner essence and the nature of character of each tribe of Israel, blessings that encompass secrets of the future as well as the past. And the verse begins with the introduction, and this is the blessing that Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death. And Rashi points out, quoting from the Sifri, on these words, this is the blessing that he blessed before his death, that this occurred close to the time of Moses' death, as the Sifri says, if not now, when? But actually, in an older edition of Rashi, he cites the tradition that it is the way of the righteous to deliver the blessing to their offspring right before their death. This was the case with our forefather Isaac, Yitzchak, that we find in Genesis 27, that he told his sons that he would bless them before his death. And according to the Midrash, the angel of death actually came to Moses to take his soul away, but Moses actually held him at bay. He held off the moment until he was able to rise up and deliver his blessing. That's how important it was to Moses, whose entire life was wrapped up with the children of Israel. That's how important it was to him to deliver this blessing. But actually, in the famed holy commentary known as the Or HaChaim HaKadosh, the Holy Light of Life, brings up a very interesting question at the beginning of his commentary, and he asks, why is this verse really necessary? Why does not the chapter begin with the text of the blessing itself? And moreover, why does the verse begin with the words Vizot HaBracha, and this is the blessing which Moses, the man of God, blessed the children of Israel before his death? Because Vizot begins with the letter Vav, that is always the connecting letter, as if to connect between this and something else, perhaps something preceding, and this is the blessing, continuation of that which was stated earlier. And one possibility that he gives is that, referring to the tradition that we just cited from that older edition of Rashi, just as there is a tradition with all of the forefathers that they delivered a blessing before they died, so too, and this is the blessing of Moses. He offers this as a possibility that Moses, joining that tradition, also joined in that pattern of the forefathers, and just as we found, for example, the blessing of Isaac recorded, so too, this is the blessing of Moses. But another possible interpretation, explanation, that the holy Rabbi Chaim ben Attar, the holy light of life, offers is really very intriguing, and that is that this Vav in Vizot HaBracha, and this is the blessing, actually connects these words to that which immediately appears in the Torah, immediately previously in the last chapter of previous portion of the Torah in Parshat Ha'azinu, where we find God telling Moses to look and see the land of Israel over the Jordan, to which his children will be passing, because he will not be going there because he did not sanctify Hashem's name in the midst of the children of Israel. And the Or HaChaim points out that this really is the continuation that shows a great deal about the character of Moshe, that even though God just told him that it was an account of the failing of his career, it was an account of this friction that he had with the children of Israel, that he would not be entering the land of Israel, the promised land, the culmination of his dreams, still this was not an issue for Moshe, and before his death the most important thing to him was to bless the children of Israel. This coming immediately after the proclamation that we read about in the previous portion, where God is telling him, look now, because this is the last time that you're going to be able to, and this is the extent of the connection that you're going to have with the land of Israel, still in all, this was the result of that incident. This is the blessing that Moses, with his whole heart, gave over to the children of Israel. And furthermore, Moses knew that as soon as he delivered the blessing, he would be leaving the world, but that also did not stop him. This is more of a testimony to the incredible character, personality, career, leadership, heart of our master Moshe, his dedication, commitment, relationship with the children of Israel. And perhaps in order for us to better understand from where he drew this tremendous power and to understand something of the tremendous, immense stature of his spirituality, perhaps we can shed some light on this mystery by the very words that appear in this verse, that he was the Ish HaElohim, he was the man of God. Because actually we find the same type of expression used in, for example, the scroll of Ruth. In the first chapter, verse 3, we find that Elimelech is called the husband of Naomi, but he's called Ish Naomi. So we understand that Ish HaElokim, the man of God, doesn't only mean a godly man, but it means something that bespeaks a very intimate relationship. Just as Elimelech was the Ish of Naomi, so too Moses himself was the man of God. And this is where he drew his immense power of understanding and compassion. That unparalleled relationship that he had with God gave him a tremendous wellspring of compassion and understanding and hope for the children of Israel. And despite the fact that he knew that this was the last act that he would perform for them, it did not stop him. This Vizota Bracha, the continuation of God's proclamation, Moses delivered the blessing to the children of Israel with all his heart.